Children, good morning. It's a good afternoon. Welcome back to your English class, Standard 4. Okay, today we are going to learn a new poem called Recess. Oh, recess. Kindly open your textbook, page number 12, and take a pencil and an eraser so that you can underline or circle or do any marking. Page number 12, it's a new poem, a recess or recess. I will explain the poem to you, then I will give you 10 minutes time to clear your doubts. If you have any doubt, you can ask me, I will clear. If you have not understood any part or any line from the poem or any word which you have not understood, you can ask me. But for that, now you mute your system and listen carefully. And pay attention and listen attentively. What is the poem telling us? What is the concept of the poem? What is there in the poem that we are going to learn? So, before I start the poem from your textbook, I want to give you a small introduction to the poem. The title of the poem says, Recess, Oh Recess. What is the meaning of recess here? What is the meaning of recess? Recess, yes, recess or recess. Recess is a general term for a period in which a group of people are temporarily dismissed from their duty. It means in educational line, recess is the American term known as break or playtime. I repeat, in education, recess is the American term known as break or playtime, where students have a mid-morning snack and play before having lunch or after a few more lessons. We have recess to give you a break. It is the period when they can relax after few periods of studies. Now when you come to school, we have 7 periods or 8 periods. We cannot have all the 7 periods or 8 periods continuously. Why? There's a reason behind it. You need a break. You need a short break or a long break, so that you relax. You relax your mind. Mute your system. Children, mute your system. So that when you attend the next session, your mind is fresh and you are ready for the next session. If I don't give you a break in between, and if I continuously keep taking classes all 7 periods and all 8 periods, you will get tired, you will get bored, and you will not understand anything. You will mix up the subjects and you will mix up the classes and lessons. So, to divert your mind, to refresh your mind, there are short breaks. In educational term, we call it as recess. Everybody, including the children and the teacher, will enjoy the break time. Because as a human being, the teacher also needs a break. The teacher also needs a break because she cannot take the class continuously. So therefore, to give a break and relaxation for some time, we have recess. So this is a beautiful poem written by Darren Sardelli. Now, what is there in the poem, we will understand only when we read the poem and what is the concept given here. Till now, whatever I have told you, that is a introduction to the poem. What is the poem about? So, children, open your textbook, page number 12, second chapter, recess, or recess. Warm up exercise or warm up for you. What three things do you do during recess? Do you think it would be fun if you have more than one recess? Why and why not? This is a question for you. You have to do it. You have to write three things you do during your recess period. Do you think it would be fun if you have more than one recess? Why and why not? So this is your personal opinion. You have to write it in three sentences below. Now, coming back to our poem, recess or recess. Now we'll see what is there in the poem. What is the poem telling us? Children, please mute your system. You are disturbing others also. There's a child there. Mute your system. No asking doubts now when I'm explaining. I give you 10 minutes. You can clear your doubts that time. Pay attention. Recess or recess. We love you. You rule. You give us a rest from a day long at school. So, the poem has beautiful lines. The poem says, recess, oh recess, we love you, you rule. You give us a rest from a day long at school. What is the meaning of this? Recess or recess? We love you. Why do we love you? Because you give us a break. You give us a break. We get a break from the long day at school. It says recess or recess. We love you. You rule. You give us a rest from a day long at school. During the recess time, during the break time, children will rush to the ground, playground. They rush to the playground. They like to play on the ground, all the toy station that is there on the ground, like slide, seesaw, swing. Or they might even play hide and seek if there is a big tree in the school playground. So the second stanza says, your swings are refreshing. Your slides are the best. You give us a break from a really hard test. So children, you are attending 3 class, 4 class, and you get tired, you get bored. So you feel like going out for a change, for a break, so that you freshen up and rejoin the class. So the child or the poet says, recess, oh recess, we love you, you rule, you give us a rest from a day long at school. Your swings are refreshing. If I go out and if I play on the swing, it is so refreshing. Your slides are the best. Your slides are the best. You give us a break from a really hard test. So these are the imagination or the child's feelings that are put into the poem. It is children who go to school and who have to sit in the school for long hours attending class, and they long for a break, they long for a recess, and they only wait when they will get a break so that they can go and enjoy their recess time. Page number 13, third stanza, recess, oh recess, we want you to know. You are sweeter than syrup. You are special like snow. The poem again is comparing the recess time, the break time, as a sweet syrup. When you eat or when you enjoy gulab jamun, there is a sugar syrup in the gulab jamun, which is very sweet. So the poet is comparing the recess time to a sweet, sweeter than the syrup. And the poet also says, you are special like snow. Children, mute your system. Somebody is talking, I can hear everything. So the poet says, recess, oh recess, we want you to know, you are sweeter than syrup. You are special like snow. You don't assign homework, you make the day fun, you let us play kickball and run in the sun. So children, when we get a short break, when we get recess time, when we go to the playground, our mind is only to enjoy that recess time, to play, to have fun. We don't think about classwork. We don't think about classwork. We don't think about assignments or homework. We only enjoy that minute or that time that is given for break. Then when we come back to class again, we think about the classes, homework, assignment, writing notes. Reshma, please mute your system. Reshma? Reshma? Is it Reshma or Roshan? Please mute your system. Mute your system. So, the poet says, recess, oh recess, we want you to know, you are sweeter than syrup, you are special like snow. You don't assign homework, you make the day fun, you let us play kickball and run in the sun. Sitting in the classroom, attending classes, 3 class, 4 class, you get tired, you get exhausted, you need a break. So when you get a break time, when you go out, you are a free bird. You don't think about writing or homework or completion of notes, nothing. You just want to enjoy that moment. The last stanza, recess, oh recess, you are first on our list. We would be in despair if you didn't exist. We are happy we have you. You are awesome and cool. Children, if you don't mute your system, I am going to remove you from the meeting. Okay, the last stanza tells us, okay, the last stanza tells us, recess or recess, you are first on a list. You would be in despair if you didn't exist. We are happy we have you. You are awesome and cool. Recess or recess, we love you, you rule. The poet has written this poem so beautifully. It is all about the break time. In the first stanza, the poet says, the recess time gives us break, it gives us rest from the classes, the ongoing classes, the writing, reading, test. So, the first stanza says, recess or recess, we love you, you rule. You give us a rest from a day long at school. Then, when recess time is there, the children go to the ground to have fun, enjoy. Your swings are refreshing. Children love to play on the swings. Slides and all the play toys or PlayStation that is available in the school playground. And when the bell rings, they don't want to come back to class. They don't want to come back to class because they are having fun, they are enjoying, they are relaxing. In the second stanza, the poet calls the recess, he compares the recess time as more sweeter than syrup. When you eat sweets, especially when you have gulab jamun, there is sugar syrup in that. Yes, which is very sweet. But here the poet says that this is time is more sweeter than the syrup. You are special like the snow. You don't assign homework. You don't assign us any activity. It's only recess. Have fun. Relax. And the last stanza tells us, recess or recess, you are first on our list. Like we have six subjects, English, Hindi, Kannada, Maths, SSC and Science. Along with these subjects, we have one games period, we have one computer period, we have one yoga period, then we have one art and craft period. So, we get so confused with all these subjects and all these classes. And when you get a break, when you have a recess time, the poet says, you are first on our list. Your name is first, break, we want a break. Want a recess time. If you would not be there, we would be in problem. We would be in problem. We would be in a situation where you would feel life very boring, tiring. And the poet also says that just like when you have all your six subjects classes, every subject teacher will give you homework. Every teacher will give you homework to do. Something or either reading or writing or finding answer or some objective or some But the recess will not give you any assignment. It will not give you any homework. It will not give you any activity. It is only that you have to go to the playground and relax yourself, refresh your mind. So the children are very happy for having a break time. So the poet says, in the last stanza, the poet says, recess, oh recess, you are first on our list. We would be in despair if you didn't exist. We are happy we have you. You are awesome and cool. Recess, oh recess, we love you, you rule. Children, this poem, the author of this poem, the poet is Darren Sardelli. He has put his imagination, he has put his ideas, he has put his thought process in this poem in a very beautiful way, comparing the recess time to many things related in life. The poem itself tells us what is the message given here. Children love the recess period. Children love break time because they get freedom to go and enjoy in the open ground. Some of them, if they don't want to play, they sit with their friends in some corner and share their feelings. They talk. But most of them, they prefer going out on the ground and play there. So this is all about the poem Recess, or Recess. What I have explained today, and I have given you a small introduction about recess time, and the poem that is mentioned in our textbook, written by Darren Sardelli. Tomorrow's class, I will show you. I will explain the poem, re-explain the poem again with the help of a PPT. So for today's